Hey everyone, I'm Sai. So this week we worked on internal trigger and I'm going to show you about some updates on it. Right, can you guys see my screen?
Yes.
So we added, so I thought we have a couple of different messages coming in for different types of events. For example, when we solve a new packet from PyPI, we have a solve message coming in. If we notice some hash goes missing in the PyPI or some other index, then we have another message coming in. And so on, we have different important messages which sort of indicate the health of package. And also security messages like CVE and other things that we get to know about. So all of this knowledge used to get stored in our knowledge base and we use it when someone requests it. But here in this last 2 weeks, we've been working towards making it more active. That is, let's say if we find out some package goes missing or if there's a hash that goes missing, we proactively try to help the user by providing knowledge based on it. So for that, we started by gathering knowledge on what kind of packages our user use. So that's what Francesco had been working on. So for all the repos that Cabochet is installed on, we collect information on what kind of package the user is using and what version and what index are they are on. Now with all of that information in hand, we have a new component that's called the Cabochet Administrator, which is connected to Investigator, and every time we get a message which is of importance to the user, like let's say hash goes missing for a particular package, we basically try finding out which all users will be affected by this new change. And once we have figured that out, then we call the Cabochet administrator with those particular hash mismatch message and the package name and the version, everything else. And then the administrator takes care of it by querying our knowledge base and figuring out the affected users. And then we're going to run Cabochet on it, and then we're going to add, and then we're going to like figure out our running our advisor. And based on the new change, we're going to make sure that the user is not affected, and we're going to probably redirect him or her to a new version. Or in case the package goes missing, then we're probably going to alert them and say that, okay, listen, this package is missing. You need to figure out how to add a different package to do the same functionality so that the user does not need to worry about these things and they can be informed in a real-time way about things that go missing or there's a new package that comes in all of these scenarios without any external trigger. We make sure that the user gets the updated version of the package. So we have been adding the components that needs to query. And we have added new message types over the last few weeks. And now we support like hash mismatch, missing packages, missing version, solved messages, and CVE provided messages. There have been few components that needs to be worked on, like adding the calling methods to the investigator and the queries needs to be reviewed. But apart from that, we are in the right track to finish it up and try experimenting. Anyone has any questions?
How can I see that? If I'm a developer and I'm sitting in front of my browser, browsing through GitHub and my repository, how can I see that stuff in action?
So you would basically get an update on like, so right now what we have is we run Cabochet on your repo if you've been affected by any of these scenarios. And in that scenario, you would see a PR that either solves the issue or we would see an issue that's created by Cabochet saying that, listen, this is the problem with your repo and you need to fix it. Either one of these interactions.
Do you think we can create a demo for that? I mean, we cannot turn a package into a missing package. But what about having an mocked up pip file with a broken hash?
Yes,
Then
we can do that.
Cabochet's. Okay.
We can create a demo package on like PyPI and even like do one of these scenarios and try it out.
Yeah, let's do that because I think really seeing in a repository what happens always helps, right?
Yes.
That is what users are or what Python developers are used to. They have a look at the pull request and see what happens. So it might be a
Right.
nice demo to just have a look at the commit history and see that there's a problem detected by Cabochet. Cabochet has fixed that problem by doing this and that. That's it, commit or pull request merge done. Cool. So if you could create such a demo, that would be a nice next step, I think, to really make that somehow complex inner working that we see tangible for human beings.
Yes. Once we are like we're waiting on a couple of PRs, once it's done, we'll probably move to them.
What? We are waiting on PRs? I thought we are creating them and forcing our colleagues to do them. Good. Any other question to Zai? Thank you, Zai. This is nice because it turns us into a more active system. That is good. Thanks.